Good morning, everybody. So on today's episode, I'm actually going to start building the pipe cleaner action figures. So I'm pretty pumped for this. I have tons of pipe cleaners, so I should be good to go. I haven't done this yet. Now, I'm following a guide I found on Google from a website called Frugal Fun for Boys, and it's essentially, they have Frugal Fun for Boys and Frugal Fun for Girls, and essentially it's just showing how to use pipe cleaners to make all kinds of different things. So in this instance, they're doing ninjas, which is pretty cool. So the things you need, let's see, I need some beads, I need my wooden head here, maybe one out of here, I don't know, let's see, and possibly some straps, so we'll start there. Alright, let's go ahead and pop this open. Not sure, I guess we'll go ahead and just start all the way on the end here, and we'll go with blue. We will create a blue character first. So, okay, following the steps. It says take three pipe cleaners and twist them together in the middle. So, and I may see if I can screenshot this for you guys, show you actually, you know, kind of what I'm looking at. And remember, I've never done this before, so I'm not 100% sure what this, exactly how this works. But, sure. Let's go ahead and see if we can get it to go. Okay, I mean, I guess it looks as good as anything, I suppose. I don't know. Maybe like this? Well, let's see. Let's just keep going. Let's do one more here. Make sure we got this good. Now it says essentially we'll take some blue here. Gotta make sure I'm kind of careful with these because I don't want beads everywhere. But alright, let's go to white. We'll do white beads. And it's saying use three. So give me a sec here, get these beads out. Okay. Exactly what we're looking at here. It looks like a starfish, but it says to go ahead and place the three beads like so. So I guess this right here where the white bead is the torso, if I had to guess. Okay. There's three. It's like arts and crafts time right now. Okay, so at the current level, you know, it's saying to cut a straw, but we'll hold off on that. So now it says to use one of the wooden beads to put on for the head. So I'm gonna use, gotta be one in here. I guess I'll try one of these, see how it goes. I guess we'll just do this. Find out if this is big enough here, which it might be, right? You're starting to see the shape of a person, so that's not bad. So, okay, essentially it's saying that now at this stage, you can kind of create the character you want. So it's referencing putting some straws on here, which, I mean, I guess I could for armor, but not necessary. I'm trying to figure out exactly. So it's saying, you know, to keep this from coming off, you just twist it a bunch of times till it is wider than that hole, which appears to be the case. So something along these lines, and then we'll cut it. Right, you can see like it kind of stays, not really. You know, let's see here. How might you get that to stay? So let's do. That is probably okay. Let's do something here. You know, okay, we'll work on evening that out. Right, you can kind of see a little figure starting to take place. Which, not bad. So, again, I may need to look at his legs. Not perfectly balanced, but Okay. So first things first, we want, you know, this is an example of like a action figure. It's a little bit smaller than what we want. So we probably want, this is probably actually pretty good, a character of this size. Let's see here. What we should do is, let's go ahead and cut this. So. We're gonna want them to be a little bit thicker than just this. So how might we do that? We're gonna wrap. Could wrap. You know, it's not the worst. So let's see. You know, you could maybe do something like that. Get a nice little thicker torso. And again, you know, I don't know if I cut it right, but not really, like one foot here is smaller than the other one. But you kind of get the idea. like, we can keep wrapping. Get a little bit thicker. You know, kind of as thick as you want to go with it. Then I might need some extra here. I just have to cut part of this off once I'm done here. Yeah, right? So there you go, right? You're getting a little bit of a thicker figure now. So what if we do arms? And maybe even, might even still be able to get at like this thicker get a straw. I was thinking maybe you could do a little armor. Maybe later. So let's say, where should his hand be? About maybe right there. Something like that. Does that look right? Does look pretty close right there. Right? So maybe we wrap up his arms, make them a little thicker. And you know, you could add all kinds of different colors. Really, whatever you want, you know. If you don't want them to be all blue, I get it. Let's see. So, to give you an idea, that's kind of what it looks like right now. So he needs a little bulk on one side here. So one of the things I'll have to do, because the pipe cleaners, you know, they're kind of sharp, you know? Like, it's not the easiest thing in the world, I guess you would say, to get stuck by one of these. You don't definitely don't want to. Okay. So next up, it's saying we should go for, let's see here. I think one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to tie a little knot around the top here. And then cut it. So let's get the head where we want it. And then I am going to do a little I'm gonna run it through. So it's almost like a knot. Voila, and then I will cut this. And then I will cut these guys. And I'll do it about maybe right there. There we go. You know, something like that. So let me get my markers here. Let's do, you know, a little Okay. And then... and we'll go ahead and... just go blue for the fun of it. These beads are a little glossy, so... the blue is, it bleeds a little bit. But we'll see how it turns out, right? Maybe once it dries, it'll look okay. If not, I may have to go find some non-glossy beads. All right, and voila! That is our first character. So, here we go. Let me show you essentially how he'll look. Okay, he is not perfect by any means, but, you know, take number one. But to give you an idea of size, then, that is how the characters will look, you know, kind of in this space. And I think it will work. Listen, that is bleeding though. So what I want to do then is, so notice how like his character doesn't just stay. So a perfect example of what I'm talking about. Let me show you. Okay, so this is the stick that I was talking about, right? This is the stick that I was talking about. So what I want to do is wrap this, right? So that this end sticks out. But I can use this, so I can use it and wrap the end of this around, say, the character's foot, right? So then they're attached to this stick, right? Now let's flip it over and see it in action. Okay. So now he's on the stick, and I can kind of move his character, you know, in and around. Like, what do you mean? And because they're pipe cleaners, like, you know, if I need to turn them or anything, they just bend. So I'm thinking something like that. And there you go. That is how the characters will interact in this story.